Hi, I'm Jeffrey Parker, bringing you What's New on the Broad. Are you ready to return to in-person worship? All members are invited and encouraged to attend a church-wide meeting on December 8th or December 15th at 6 p.m. to ensure you and your family are prepared for the return to God's house on the Broad, January 2nd, 2022. You can attend the meeting either in person or online. However, everyone must register. Check your emails now for the registration link. Calling all men, especially ages 18 to 35. Baptist Memorial Healthcare and the Center for Transforming Communities are hosting a special men's health information event for men ages 18 to 35 to learn more about and discuss vital health issues affecting our communities, including the importance of regular health screenings, reproductive health, cancer prevention, diabetes, and much more. Dinner is provided, and random drawings for prizes will occur throughout the event. This event will be hosted at First Baptist Church Broad, Tuesday, November 30th. Health screenings begin at 4. Register today.
Hi, I'm Martrice Caswell. As we prepare to come back in 2022, if you would like your child to be dedicated, please submit your child's name, parents' name, to mcaswellfbcb@aol.com.
Hi, I'm Pastor Keith Norman. I'm the senior pastor of First Baptist Church Broad Avenue, and I'm also the CEO of the Broad Avenue Community and Economic Development Corporation. I've been in this role for 22 years now, and what a privilege and what a joy it has been. Welcome to Giving Tuesday, a time that has been set aside for the generosity of humanity to contribute to organizations that are doing great work all across the United States. I'm here today to tell you a little bit about the great work that I believe is taking place right here in Binghamton, Tennessee. Binghamton is the core, the center, if you will, of Memphis, Tennessee. And our work extends from the church at 2835 Broad Avenue and also from 2900 Broad Avenue, our Broad Avenue Community and Economic Development Headquarters and Athletic Complex, into all of Memphis and even throughout Tennessee and across the world. I'm thankful today to lead this organization. Why is this important? It's important personally to me because of the pride and the sense that I have of being a part of something that is far greater than me. I believe that the African American church has been a part of the development of so many wonderful things in the United States of America, and we are making our contribution here and now. African American churches have given birth to HBCUs, historically black colleges and universities, and so many other organizations across the United States. Even the NAACP and other organizations draw their roots back to, maybe not their inception, but their affiliation to the black church all around the United States of America. And it's the personal pride that I have in this generation to lead an organization that is continuing that great work. We send young men and young women into college every year. We support them through our scholarships. We make sure that those who have fallen into the cracks of life, whether it is through homelessness or lack of medical care and assistance, or even those who just find themselves overwhelmed by life in grief and other ways, are supported through the church. It is through your generosity, it is through your kindness that we are able to do this work. It has not always been easy to be able to do this. Developing a community and giving pride and a sense of resurgence to what it means to be an African-American church in a community that has been overlooked and sometimes forgotten. So that's why we chose to remain in the city of Memphis, Tennessee. While we had opportunity to go all around to other areas that may have been more affluent, that may have had a larger home base or home ownership base, we chose to remain in Binghamton. We know that Binghamton is one of the poorest zip codes and most underserved zip codes in the city of Memphis. And so a great sense of pride to be here and to be a part of what it takes to lift people up whom some may have forgotten or some may have overlooked. So we remain here for that particular purpose. I'm thankful to the ancestors of this church who helped to found this ministry and to leave it for us to build on. I've been here, as I shared with you, 22 years. And so many of my colleagues and my friends and the members of this church have joined me. Thousands literally have come since the time that I began my service here. And they have played an important part of building on the foundations that our ancestors have left for us. I applaud you, those of you who are in that area of life right now, where you can look at your significant service and you can say, I have been a part of something great and something bigger than me. When I came to First Baptist Church, we had one building and we were trying very hard to make sure that our campus would not be taken over by anything or anyone else. So we fought hard to get our congregation out of debt and to lay a foundation for the future. Now we have built two churches. We're building a park. We own land in our community. We own homes in our community. And we're making sure that people have a bright future. I'm grateful to those of you who have come alongside me in this 25-year vision that I believe the Lord has given to us in this present day. But guess what? I'm not tired yet. I'm not ready to give up or to quit. I want to see it through. That's why I'm challenging you, the members, friends, and those who are watching this video to give to First Baptist Church and, if you choose to the Broad Avenue Community and Economic Development Corporation. Both are ministries in this community that do good for all of those who come to our doors. Our goodwill is not limited to Binghamton. We make sure that we take care of anyone whom comes into our bandwidth where we can serve them and meet their needs. If they're in South Memphis, North Memphis, as far away as Jackson, Tennessee, and even to South Haven, Mississippi, East Memphis, and to other parts of our community, we know how to find you. And when you come to us, our doors are open. We're glad to support the schools in our community. We're glad to support the young people in our community. And this year, we've even given birth to a school right here in our church. But it takes your generosity to make all of that happen. It takes your kindness and it takes your gifts to make it happen. I don't ask you to do anything that I don't personally commit to myself, and I don't ask you to do anything that I don't challenge my staff to do. So I'm sending out some challenges. I'm sending out some challenges to those of you who made a commitment to Christ by joining this ministry, those who were here before I ever got here. Make this a part of your annual giving. Make this a part of your legacy giving. Make this a part of your historic endowment. Those of you who came alongside me when I came here 22 years ago and you've been at this church or you return to this church, don't forget about the commitments we made to Christ, that we would build on a firm foundation and that we would lead going into the next century. And then for those of you who are our children who come along and even been birthed, as you are coming into your wealth, and you are finding ways of stability through your employment and the various vocations that you may have even learned about or were inspired to take on right here through this church, or if you were sustained by that small scholarship that you received every 6 months from this church, give back. It's time to sow as the Lord has blessed you. Finally, I want to share this with you. There are 25 years in the thoughts that I have for what can happen here on this plot of what John McKay and others have referred to as hallowed ground, land that the Lord set aside for us to develop and to do great works. I remember Deacon John Parker, who inspired me to remain right here in this community. He said, stay here because the older people can't get to you if you go a long way away. I'll forever remember those words. So here's my challenge. I want to challenge members of the Divine Nine. Let's get into a competition about something good like giving. I believe the Omegas are going to win, but I invite the rest of you to try. Let's get into a football challenge. Let's see who has the best team. So when you give your gift, you can put Pittsburgh Steelers or Kansas City Chiefs, or there are a couple of teams in Texas that you can mention. Their names slip my mind right now. Maybe you're a baseball fan. Everybody loves the Atlanta Braves now. So I would suggest to you, maybe you do it in that manner. Whatever it is, let's challenge and compete on something good. Finally, I want to raise my voice to an issue that's taking place that our church is also a part of: stopping the violence in our city. We have a lot of violence in our city, and we must be involved in being a part of the solution and not just the criticism. There are people who need to get involved and to do more, and we want to make sure that we're doing our part. We are working with organizations around the city to make sure that there are activities available, but not just activities, training and opportunities for counsel and even peer mediation. We need young people to know how to solve their problems without using violent acts. When you give to these organizations, rest assured that we direct those resources to healthy and helpful ways to make sure our communities are good. You've known me over the last 22 years. We've never had a building fund that we did not use for the purposes in which we received the gifts. When I said we were going to have a building, even when people didn't believe, we now have two. We built two churches on the same hallowed ground. One is now a life center, the other one is our sanctuary. When we do things, the Lord blesses it, and we accomplish His will. You are sowing into what I believe is good ground. God bless you on this Giving Tuesday, and throughout this year, continue to support this ministry.
My name is Frankie White.
And I'm Pamela White.
We have been a member here at First Baptist for almost 2 years.
Yes. Why is giving important to me? Giving is important to me first and foremost because Scripture teaches us that we're supposed to give our 10% tithe. And I believe that when we don't tithe the way God tells us to, then we are stealing from God, and that's not what we want. We should be doing.
And giving is important to me because it is God's plan for us to support the church. That's how He came about in the means of supporting the church, through tithing. And the church, we have to look at it this way. The church is just like any other business. They have finances and things that they have to take care of for us to keep up people of the building. Everyone must remember that we are the church as a people, but we come here to First Baptist to worship, and there are expenses involved in the upkeep of this house of God. So that's why I think giving is important to me.
As far as any personal testimony I have, it's just that once I actually took tithing seriously and tried to stick with it no matter what, you know, it says the more we give, the more He gives to you. You know, I have always had my needs. I have not had to suffer for any needs. There's some things that I want that I don't have yet, but I know that God will take care of my needs and some of the desires of my heart.
And a personal story for me is that, you know, before I started tithing, because I think tithing is a growth process. You have to learn to grow into it. And once I started and really put my faith and trust in God, I just really saw how He started blessing me as I did and was obedient to His word. So I just know that if you give, He will give back. And like I say, He'll pour out a blessing that you just cannot hold. So that's my testimony, because I know what God can do because I have seen what He has done.
And what I would say to someone who's having trouble with tithing today, I would say if you are truly a Christian, if you have truly accepted God as your Savior, and that's what He's instructed us to do, just try it. And you'll see the difference in your life.
And just like anything else, I think you have to step out on faith. If you believe and have faith, I think you will be amazed at what God can do. But you must have faith and believe that He's true to His word. So I would encourage anyone, just step out on faith and just try God and see what He'll do.
I am Vera Dean Wright Tolbert. Proud to say I've been at First Baptist Church on Broad Avenue for 12 joyous years. Giving is so important. Why? Mentally, it's good for you. I find inner peace. I'm inspired to give, for I've seen the results of what giving will do. Mentally, your worries are gone because now you realize that God provides, and all He asks of us is to share your wealth, share your blessings. For when He blesses me, I can bless someone else. Oh, it's important physically because I am socially connected. Socially connected with my members at First Baptist. And we feel that when we give, that is love in action. Now, it's highly important because it is a way of life. And I find now, as I think of it, I am a total package. I believe in spiritual growth, mental growth, and also financial growth. It allows you to trust and believe that the provider is the good shepherd. Now, as a personal testimony, I must admit, at one point and several points in my life, I've been very selfish, but I do have a husband and I have to give him credit who believes in giving. I was selfish and I would give but a 10%. That took me a while. Now I feel great about it because I've seen at First Baptist Broad that there is an awareness of accountability. We actually can see the growth. We can see the finances. We are a benevolent giving church. I have been able to witness and just see how this church loves to reach out and help others. Our overall mission is to help and to love. If today you are struggling with tithing, it is my advice to you that you pray and give that over to God. Let's say you have $20 right now and you're wondering, how am I going to give? God said, just give me $2. And I will tell you that in my life, there have been times when you're trying to decide, do I pay the light bill? Or do I put this money in church? I've been there. Do you pay the light bill or do you pay the car note? My advice to you, until you become the total package, you will forever wrestle with finances. But I'm a living witness. I've been there. I've been through the struggle. But now, I find inner peace, tranquility. Giving is not a problem, for I've learned I can't be God-given, and I've also learned that the more I give, the more He gives to me, and the more I give, the happier I am in Christ Jesus. I'm the toll package. Thank you.
Hi, I am Kendra Moore. I'm the Director of Children and Youth Discipleship Development here at First Baptist Church Broad. When the school system went virtual, we purchased necessary supplies for students at our adoptive schools. We also provided coats for Operation Warm Hearts for Shelby County School students as well. We've also given away backpacks to over 300 students during the pandemic. We also were able to have a trunk-or-treat where our community was able to come out in great numbers. Well over 250 families were able to come out and enjoy themselves. We were even able to decorate ornaments with Habitat for Humanities to give to families who are going to be able to move into their new home. This is why it's very important for you to continue to give, so we're able to continue to do the things that we are doing here.
To my heart. Mm-hmm. I love doing this. I love feeding community. I love being in food, period. So whenever we can feed other people, it's a blessing to me. So I just, you know, I thank God that I'm able to do it. I thank God that we are able to do it as one. And for all the ones that have come out to volunteer to help. As you can see, we got an overflow of plenty of food, warmers down, oven still going. Bro Ross has been working tireless for the last couple of days, cooking and prepping to make sure we have everything that we needed for today. So I definitely want to thank him from the bottom of my heart for coming out to help me to get it started. Happy Thanksgiving, everybody.
Thank God for another blessed day. Not just because it's the national day that we give thanks corporately with our families and friends and loved ones, but every day is truly a day to thank God for all of. I admonish everyone to take time and just think. Breathe in and breathe out. Thank God for that. God bless you. Enjoy your day.
Coming in, need a place to stay, or just hang out. And it'll help you with life. And then when you start developing family and children and all that stuff, you'll be surprised how you pick up the phone and call somebody and say, my daughter coming to town, she's trying to get in. He said, I'm in charge of that, I'll get them hooked up. That's a network that black men need to make good use of and develop for the rest of their life. That's good stuff, y'all. Y'all look good, man. Get out there and do your thing today.
Thank you.
Hello, my name is Craig Freeman. I'm the Executive Pastor of Operations here at First Baptist Church Broad. And we are here to stress the importance of Giving Tuesday. And I think it is so important. I've been affiliated with First Baptist Church now for almost 20 years as a member here. And I've seen the growth, and I've seen the improvements to the entire campus. And I've just seen all of those things since I've been here. And one reason that giving is important to me, first of all, from the staff perspective, is we do know that giving is biblical. And it's a biblical principle that God has asked and stressed. But the thing that I like to do is bring it and make it a little bit more personable. But as a staff member here of the church, the importance of giving that I have seen from my perspective and overseeing all of our operations is that, first of all, it's right to do it, and then secondly, it helps in all of the ministry related things that occur here at the church. So just for instance, when you come to church, you want to be able to come to church where you can flip a switch and lights turned on. You want to be able to come and go into a clean facility. So giving helps to support the support personnel, like our custodial team and our maintenance staff. And then also giving helps to support a lot of the technology upgrades that we tend to do. As we see, things are going virtual now, so we want to make sure and ensure that we present the best product to our congregation. And then also, we don't want you to have a lot of downtime and have a lot of problems with the streaming going forth. So giving helps to support technology upgrades and all the improvements that we try to do. We want to make sure that all aspects of HVAC systems, giving helps to maintain those systems. And then when you come onto the parking lot, we don't want you to have to experience a lot of potholes and a lot of bumps and a lot of things of that nature. So giving helps to support all of those things, to whereby we continuously make improvements to the entire campus. And so from my perspective, and as I see it, it is only right to be able to participate in giving and giving of your tithes and offerings. And so that's why it's so important to me, is because I see the benefit of it. I see all the improvements that we go on, but it cannot be done without your gifts. And so we just continue to encourage those. You may have heard myths about where the money goes or all these type of things, But I just encourage you not to listen to those myths, but to just stay true to the biblical principles of God, and just stay true, and you'll be able to see all the things and all the improvements that have taken place here, and you can see where your gifts are going. So I give out of faithfulness, I give out of cheerfulness, I give because I desire to see all these things take place at First Baptist Church Broad. Giving helps to enhance and give forth ministry, outreach, and all those things. So it's just important for us to participate, and I'm so thankful, I wasn't always a giver and a tither, but over time, God has shown me the benefits of giving. And so I just enjoy doing it. I give it out of cheerfulness when I give and tithe. I don't look back on it and say, I could have done this or could have done that. You know, God has blessed me to earn a living. And so I'm just giving back some of what God has blessed me to have. So on this day, just continue. Want to encourage you to, not only for today, but throughout, just continue to give and tithe and be a supporter of your ministry, because there are many things that are going on here, including the improvement and building of a brand new sports complex that all of us will have an opportunity to share in. But it takes your gifts in order to see that vision come to fruition. So continue to give, because one day we'll be able to have picnics on the sports complex. We'll be able to play games, be able to have Easter egg hunts in a safe place on the sports complex, be able to walk in a healthy environment. So that's what your gifts and your giving does for this church. And so as a staff person, I'll be one of the first ones to give and make sure that I am giving and that I am a participator and a supporter of all the ministry activities here at the church and all of the things that we intend to do. So again, we encourage it, and we pray that you would just continue to be a faithful giver and tither and supporter of this ministry. God bless you.
Thank you for watching this Giving Tuesday broadcast. There's also an opportunity for me to thank vendors and supporters. We've had many friends to come alongside us in the 22 years that I've been a part of this ministry. Let me personally thank you. You know who you are if you're watching this video. We chose not to expose this group of people to the entire world because we don't want people soliciting or calling, but we do want to say thank you. It's important that you know that we treasure your participation. Thank you to the members and friends of this congregation. Thank you to the members and friends of Broad Avenue Community and Economic Development Corporation. Thank you to people all over the world. If you sent $1 or if you sent $1 million, we appreciate you. We have always believed that it is not the equal giving that matters, it's the equal sacrifice. It's when a person says, this is what I can afford to do, and whatever you do, whether it's cash apping $2 or whether it's mailing a check for $2 million, it is all treasured right here by this ministry. Thank you again for your giving. Thank you again for your support.